fired when? We boil water.
Heating it to 212 degrees Fahrenheit.
It changes from a liquid to a gas we call steam. And steam has a lot of energy stored in it. See how it forces its way out of the spout? People have known about the power of steam since ancient Greece.
I think that's what they cook these fries in. Ancient Greece.
No, Lester, not that kind of Greece. He means Greece, the country.
Correct as usual, Lysola. A great Greek hero by the name of Hero created the very first steam engine in the first century A.D. This thing is just a tea kettle with three spouts. When the steam comes out of these spouts, or jets, it turns Hero's engine around. Steam power.
What did Hero use this thing for?
Well, that's the trouble. He never figured out what to use it for.
You're fired!
But it wasn't until 1,600 years later that people finally put steam to work. They did it using one of these guys. A piston in a cylinder. Wow! Now check this out. The steam from the boiler goes through this valve here. A valve is like a door. And into this side of the cylinder, where it pushes the piston this way as far as it'll go. When that happens, this valve closes, and the valve on the other side opens. Then, the steam pushes the piston back the other way. The piston goes back and forth, and as it does, it turns this flywheel right here. Now, in a steam locomotive, steam pushes the piston back and forth in this cylinder here, pushing and pulling these rods. The rods turn the drive wheels, and that sends the train along its merry way for a peaceful ride over hill and dale. Unless, of course, someone's asleep at the switch.
Ouch.
Wow, steam trains are so neat. How come they're not still around?
Actually, they are still around. Ray? Oops, wrong chain. Steam locomotives were built as early as the 1830s, but were hardly in use at all by the 1960s. But there are dozens of beautifully restored steam railroads all over the country for you to ride on. This is the Durango-Silverton Narrow Gauge Railroad in Colorado. It's a museum on wheels. Today, passengers and freight travel mostly by diesel-electric locomotives. They're cheaper to build, cheaper to run, and they don't have to stop every few miles for water. Thanks for your letter, Max and Zoe Keller of Sherman Oaks, California. That's our crash course on the Iron Horse.
What will the train of the future look like? I'll give you a hint. It won't have any wheels. So stick around for the